number 10 of 1,500. Hello, thank you for watching. First things first, we do have a Twitter. Follow us there, and we also have an Instagram, and we will be doing something very special with our Instagram. I will explain later. Facebook is too, is up and running, and follow us right here if you're watching on YouTube. If you are watching on our website, www.allsaygames.com. Thank you so much. You are an absolute superstar for watching it there. We have a discuss feed, so you can post kind of relevant kind of data or information more lengthy, discussions for posting. These are my paintings, and I think this should be my part two of Brexit and Trump, part two, right? I'm just gonna keep going on. I think I might be on a roll here. So let's carry on going. So Brexit and Trump back then, all throughout, a little bit now, and like, yeah, keep going. So yeah, it was, you know, policies and stuff, right? Every president. Okay. And like Brexit. Okay. So where we were. Alright, so this, our Trump is our Farage, right? Our Farage. So trade policies enacted by every president. Alright. Let me go. So Farage had a near-death car crash at the age of 21, right? Let's go. Near-death car crash at age of 21. Cheated death with a bout of cancer at 24. At death's door once more in a plane crash at 46. A life like the superhero script. No wonder he fears none of the remaining globalists. Sleepwalking into a new 21st century form of /communism/corporatocracy/despotism/authoritarianism/anti-democratic/anti-peopleism. Whatever this is, the hero's journey is alive and well in Mr. Farage. He's the little boy telling the EU Emperor 2 to put some body clothes on, for heaven's sake, you're stalkers. He's Moses screaming, "Let my people go," at the EU at the time, Pharaoh. Only this time, Nigel needs no one's worship. Christ didn't exactly fall to the EU at that time in the form of the Roman Empire, you know. It's Hong Kongers today lashing out at the EU in Beijing. However, futile in the long run, because, you know, no one should be answering the call of two governments, right? We aren't stupid. We know in actuality only one is in control, right? We have two governments, one control the other. But we aren't free, and they aren't being held accountable. They can keep rebranding the same hellish authoritarian case every single generation in a new ism, right? Globalism is now, but whatever. It's like more heroes will arise, right? More, like, not just Farage, but all of us, right? More heroes will arise to defend the people and stick to principles and definitions, okay? They will never get full control over us, right? It's not quite USSR CCCP this time, but there will not be a FUGLIE, fugly, federalized union of globalist lackey idiots, you know, but instead a pragmatic, symbiotic, freely collaborative relationship between independent sovereign nations the world over, right? Because they represent the bottom of the person, the lowest form, the lowest, the luck of the person with no power. That's all they have, is the low power ratio between them and the people they see who represent them, right? So it's collaborative relationship between independent sovereign and nations the world over, right? And at the will of their people, their own people, not of big money, right? That are left alone to secure progress and cultural affinity for their people, just like a democracy demands, yes? No two wealthy, functional, sovereign nation-state modern democracies have waged war on each other. Is that true? I believe it's so. So, no two mature, wealthy, functioning, sovereign nation-state modern democracies have waged war on one another. Wow, what a revelation. What a revelation. The Book of Revelations. Okay, now, okay, here's another one. There were calls by some self-hating internationalists and leftist useful idiots in the UK to give in to the threat of Nazism and fascism 80 years ago. Say that again. So the same kind of personality type who just latches on to a new Fandango kind of idealism. So it's new ideology, new upper middle class or wannabe middle class or wannabe elite, but there's no way they're going to get there, because you should be looking not up or down, you should be looking left or right, looking around you, left and right, and uniting. Don't look up to your masters, look left and right. look forward together, you know. They were caused by this kind of personality, self-hating kind of new ideology kind of people, right? They don't understand the basics of the definitions of what the common man is and its relationship to power. You're not the common man has the power, you see what I'm saying, you know. Useful idiots. They, some of them were like, oh, let's give in to Nazism, let's give in to fascism, let's give in to communism, all those 80 years ago. It's the same type to cozy up to actual communists, these kind of people, actual totalitarians. They're so willing to give away their freedom and their power. It's beta male nonsense. You know, these feeble minds always exist and wield an inordinate power. That's why we need leadership, right? Nigel Farage is one of a rare kind of breed, you know? No free, wealthy people has ever voluntarily given up its sovereignty. Think about it. We don't do that. That's why we have freedom, you know? First, they demoralize you. They hoodwink you into thinking you are weak and hapless. So-called victimhood, right? And so-called, we're the fourth most powerful country in the world at the time. For heaven's sake, victimhood? Good Lord, take a look at yourself. It's ridiculous. In a strange way, the authoritarian leftist remainers deserve something for just the complete flipping of reality. They have no shame at all. As a matter of fact, we consist of the modern world's most... Listen, the lion's share, the kind of Anglo kind of mentality. The Anglos consists of modern world's most altruistic stock, the most altruistic people of all of humanity, the least ethnocentric, right? According to all the evidence, according to the Hofstede's culture and the Pew research and all the global survey, you know, global values survey, you know, it's with the most altruistic people in the world. And that is the metric for love thy neighbor, anti-racism, open-mindedness, research, you know, research after research reminds us of this. You know, we consistently cluster among the world's top 10, whether home or in the British Isles or in our numerous startup nations, whom we still maintain a healthy ties with. Another unheard of success. Who keeps healthy relationships with the colonies? We do, because we spread the same virtues, right? Share the same freedom, independence, the same democracy, the same egalitarian, the same... Not this new nonsense that it's spreading. It's like a cancer amongst our society. I don't know, but it's not very Anglo, it's not blighty, it's not us. You know, and to add a special relationship with a special relationship with let's say one third of the world's population? Wow. That's some nation we are here. This is the reason why the world's most diverse cities are ours. We were multicultural before it was even cool. In Sydney, Auckland, Toronto, New York City, Los Angeles, London, Cape Town, Birmingham. Come on, people. Obviously Paris and etc. and everyone else. But look, we did it first, you know. But just as, no, actually maybe they did it first. But anyway, look, we're still doing it, and we're doing it globally on a scale. But just as with all good things, everything in moderation. At scale. But again, the evil empire EU cannot let people know who they really are. That's themselves. So they spread all this divisive dogma and create a hateful narrative that makes you hate yourself and your neighbor. Anyone in a position of manipulative power is held into account, but that doesn't mean showing every side of the story. It means not having a narrative, okay? The Guardian, Economist, Daily Mail, Channel 4, even Breitbart all proudly admit to having a narrative. Reality doesn't have a narrative. It is complex, so the media should be duty-bound to present all the relevant perspectives, right? In order to reveal the whole picture. More information delivery and less shaping of public opinion, okay? We are smart enough to make up our minds, or thank you very much, okay? Thank you very much. We are smart enough. That's an enlightenment value, you know. It was never the lower working class lumpen proletariat who created all of these horrors in society. It was the arrogant, ignorant, ideological, kind of narcissistic, self-centered, just manipulative, dumb in the sense of dull, in the sense of they don't think, they don't use anything in their skull. They just follow and ape the norms and say, oh, it's okay if I just do this, yeah, it's okay if I don't start thinking with my mind. You know, it's like emoting all the time, you know, mainstream, here we go. More information delivery, less shaping of public opinion. So mainstream media, by curating the topics they alone deem open to discussion, the public are left with no option but to seek information online and often through what you call, okay, let's say, less reputable sources. But thank goodness for them, right? Thank goodness for them, as they are the only ones delivering them the crucial information, the other perspectives that the public needs, you know? This devalues the mainstream media, and it's small wonder they've been wrong about pretty much everything this past 12 months, right? Oh, 12 months. This is what I wrote then. I told you, okay, let's say this past 4 years, right? Always playing catch up, the elites, right? They won't bother opening their eyes to what's really happening. They're just, you know, ostrich paralytic kind of syndrome, ostrich head in the sand, right? It doesn't suit their narrative, right? In this scenario, you know, it doesn't suit them. It's like I'm gonna time Channel 4, like, just showed BBC as well, and CNN kind of manipulating the fake news when it was setting up this thing. It's like hot. It's just so embarrassing for them. And everyone knew what was going on. It's like, why must they stick to this narrative of Muslims being solely victims? Doesn't make any sense. Just look at the big picture. The mountains of facts. I mean, you don't think we can find that? We know how to do our research, you idiots. You know what I mean? Like, just, do you not know, like, this in evidence and information on communities disproportionately causing, like, widespread terror, or like, you know, what we saw in the northern towns in England and all of it. It's like, hello, like, what's going on here? Like, you're supposed to be the news, all that's fit to news, all that's fit to print, all that news that's all that's fit to print, right? What was that saying? Anyway, so it doesn't fit the narrative, right? Just that they pretty much ignore disproportionate levels of black crime as well. I mean, like, we're not infants. We know what we're doing. We're not babies. We know what's going on. Like, surely you should hold us to the same bloody standards, right? Yet, always on hand to report whenever a white police officer does wrong to a black person and get black people riled up and angry, causing riots. What's 2011? Oh my God. Like, seriously? Like, this is not what a powerful news organization should be. I mean, if you think it's okay to have single narratives pushed constantly to the public, then we might as well be living in communist China or North Korea. Don't get any ideas, yeah? So some of the smartest people I have ever known and grew up with, I prefer to be around smart people because I don't learn shit, you know? I prefer to be around people better than myself, smarter than myself. Like, how else am I going to know? But then I realized that the correlation between IQ and discovery and, you know, motivated reasoning and self-sealing kind of false survival beliefs and there is no kind of, like, it doesn't mean you know more about everything, it just means you know more about your position, right? So I was like, oh my God, even the smartest people are failing me. Oh, what do I do? I have to go through all of this. I have to do it myself, you see? Some of the smartest people coming, congratulating me. Oh, thank you for putting these perspectives. Like, you know, why that's why I put the effort in, because if we aren't being challenged, then we simply aren't learning anything, right? History isn't there just for some of us to pass GCSEs. It's meant to teach us something, you see? You know, multiculturalism with liberalism, the great noble lie of our generation, another one. Do not try to radically alter society. Communism failed. Nazism failed. Multiculturalism, liberalism, fail. The majority of any group will always revert back to tribe and back to resources. Acknowledgement of this is critical to avoid all the pain and suffering and cyclical errors and reboots, you know? Yeah, it's gonna be a reboot, and, you know, none of us will be here to see it. We're all just gonna be kapooked, you know? People have been reluctant to accept the failings of such a kind of multiculturalism because of the emotive aspect of this noble lie and the ostracism and the bullying of the powers. And the powers could just be a person next to you, could be a friend who just smug, arrogant, kind of takes himself way too seriously, you know, calling out anybody who challenges it with facts. Calling all facts, reality, racist, xenophobic, Islamophobic, bigot, fascist, boycott, cancel, and so on. This is just history repeating itself. If you actually go and do the research yourself. Like, I mean, this isn't sustainable, and with the internet age exposing all in the world to not only the truth, but also vast differences in real time, you got yourself the century's greatest cause of conflict, right? It's our generation's ism. Notice how wealthy East Asia and the Middle East want nothing to do with any of this nonsense the West is doing. Well, not for it, and not for now. Like, just like the previous great destructive isms, they all originate in the West. Funny that. Funny that. Such as the other one, and the other one, yeah, all of them are really, really bad, and this one is just as bad. Wait for it. Trust me, you haven't seen the worst of it. We're only starting it, right? Okay. Remember what they said about that and that and that when it was supporting it. You know, I'm not going to stand idly by and watch people destroy themselves. Neither is Trump. This is what I said then. And it's still as it was then, it's still as it is now. It took the internet to stop this cycle of history, right? Surely this freedom of information, this is the Gutenberg press, you know, Trump benefited from the internet age's power to give an equal voice to the naysayers and to present truths that were not available to combat history's other great transformative moments and mistakes, right? This is no left or right. It's not left or right anymore. When you have a confluence between wrong thinkers all around the spectrum, you know, boy, girl, different kind of look.
Okay, now for the difficult part. That was difficult, but this is difficult in another way. So every day I will endeavor to post a video of my thoughts, my paintings and my perspectives, or other people's perspectives, not just mine. This is all a collage of thoughts. I will do one a day. If it takes longer than expected, I might even post two or three a day, just so I can get the 1,500 of them done, maybe over 300, 400 maybe paintings. It's all ideas, aesthetics, it's all people, it's things that are people find interesting, people find fascinating. Not necessarily I find interesting or fascinating, but they are for some, and that is enough. So I need to fund this, and this is the way I'm funding it, this way. The yellow, the pink, the white, the black, the grey you see me wearing, you can wear that or more. I have 15 different colours. We have 15 colours on the website. I hope you're watching on the website. You can buy now here and here and here, and everything is just very straightforward. And also it will show the community of people who do like to think. Community of curious people. Who don't take themselves too seriously, but take beauty, ideas, and other people's perspectives very seriously. And it's wonderful to have this community. So I will post on Instagram. Some of you who want to be posted on the Instagram, so you get a bit of Insta fame. That's when you buy the t-shirts, upon point of sale, I will get into contact and say, hey, would you like to be featured on our Instagram? And we have a whole list of the community. It's just a wonderful thing. And thank you for supporting, and here is the link, and thank you so much.